Okay, we'll run this nice little Tangy from Birmingham engine. Nicely built model. Interesting flat belt pulley here with wood on it. Wood slats on it. Nice valve. I think it's a faux governor. It looks real, but it doesn't seem to do much. And we'll start it with about 4.5-5 pounds. There we go. That's about 10 PSI. And we're back to near 5. And about 4.5. Engine is, I believe, somewhat based on Cole's Corliss parts, a few of them anyway. Like this, and the crankshaft, I mean the connecting rod and crank. And the governor is clearly not a Cole's governor, but it certainly looks like it was made to work, although it's not hooked up, it's plugged off. Maybe there is an air inlet right there. And I think the timing is probably well off on this one. It's hooked up to the governor, but this is 25 PSI. I think we'll have to work on it a little. The governor will work. Okay, we'll try this little PM Research twin cylinder engine. There's 10 PSI. There's about 6 PSI. Nice tick over speed. I like those little megaphone exhausts. And that's 15 PSI. Here's another little PM Research engine. That's 5 PSI, you see right here. That's 15 PSI, and we'll bring it back down. There's 2.5. And that should be around 2 or a little less. Nice flat belt pulley there. And that's it for now. And here's a really nicely made little Stewart S50. There's 4 PSI. And that's about 6.5 PSI. This shows virtually no signs of wear. And this one takes about 7-8 pounds to run. It's a little high-speed steam engine, a small one as you can see. Very nicely made. The battery's gone. Here's a really nicely designed oscillating steam engine. It's a pretty large one, as you can see by my hand. It comes with its own little wrench, and I believe this is for, you can open these with it, or these, and something for the other end, of course. Probably the main bearing caps would come off with this end of it. And we're going to run it now, and we'll start it off on about 5 PSI, maybe 6. Well, I guess it doesn't need that much. It's a very well-made engine. It has 4 main bearings. Very robust construction. Will work hard. There's quite a bit of pull. Well, it's about 3.5 to 4 PSI. She runs pretty smoothly. You can get an idea of the size of it here by looking. Here's a Boucher twin cylinder, and here's a Stewart beam to put next to it. You can see it's a pretty stout engine. Now here's a very interesting little piece. This is what is known as, it's an unusual piece, it's known as a water motor. It'll run on air or steam, but it'll also run on water pressure. And you can see it rocks. The port face has a curve on it, and so does this block under it. Not your typical oscillator at all. By the way, this is on, what's that, about 1 PSI. That's about 4 PSI. Runs very easy. Nice little engine, and it'll run in both directions just as well. If you just plug the plug your air line on the other side, it'll run the other direction. Maybe I can demonstrate it. It won't stay, but I might be able to hold it. There we go. There, you see, that works that way too. Okay, now we're going to give a test run of this nice little Stewart beam. Cleaned it up a little bit. Let's see. I think 3.5, 4 pounds is plenty. Very nicely built engine. Smooth as silk. And that's 7.5 to 8 pounds air pressure. That's about 3 PSI. Let's turn it around and have another look at the other side. Yeah, that's a sweet Stewart beam. It's got some weight to it too, with that heavy metal plate under it. It weighs nearly 22 pounds. I hope you enjoyed it.